Sweet. Just one word means everything. Sweet not only plays an important role as one of the food tastes, but also plays an indelible role in the culture of human diet. Sweet brings more than 1,000 taste buds on the tongue with pleasure and enjoyment. In the world of ingredients, sweet shows its unique personality, which enables us to feel the taste of the tip of the tongue in our daily meals. Sweet can also be used as a synonym for happiness in people's lives. It can be used as an indispensable connection and adjustment in human-to-human communication, in the warmth of sweet words, in the sweetness of passionate love between couples. God gives us this wonderful sweet taste as one of the most attractive tastes in the world. It is just like the prosperity of life. In the changing between sweet and bitter, only love can be used to feel the beauty of it. In Preston, this peaceful and small town, when passers-by go along the street toward the city center, the sweet smell of cake coming out of the oven often can be smelled by them. On this street, a unique and exotic cafe is located over there. The name of this lovely store is called Kafune. Livia, as the hostess of Kafune, can be regarded as the best interpreter of sweet. Every day, Livia is soaked in the sweet smell of the store and winces the coming guests who have been shutting in and out of the world. They only want to come here to feel that sweetness at the tip of the mouth, bringing them the moment of happiness and joy. A few years ago, Livia came all the way from Brazil to start her dream over here. At first, she wanted to visit the birthplace of her husband, but after she arrived here, Livia made a life-changing decision that she decided to stay here. That decision began with the dream to bring an amazing South American coffee, to let more British people try the wonderful Brazilian taste. Now, let's start the marvelous story about Livia and her Brazilian dessert.
I always loved all the culture about my continent, South America, and I always had passion like to interact with people and to cook and to serve in coffee. So me and my husband, we put this together and then we brought a little bit of this diversity from South America to Preston because we noticed that there wasn't anything like this before as well. Brazil is one of the biggest producers of coffee, so we have a very strong coffee culture back in Brazil. If you go to visit someone in Brazil, the first thing that they're going to offer you is, oh, would you like a cup of coffee? It's like a welcoming thing for us. Bringing this to Preston is not only offering a drink, it's offering a whole experience of welcoming and like feel like home. You come to Cafuné and I'm not only giving people a drink, I'm giving people a South American experience. We want to keep making our cakes like fresh, homemade, like we do now, so people can taste like real food, something made when their moms cook for them.
The desserts in the shop are all made by Livia and her family. In Kafune, they sell handmade Brazilian desserts to their guests.
We have like one that's our signature one, that is the Brazilian custard cake. Everybody in Preston loves it. They really cannot find this cake anywhere in this country. It's very traditional from my region in Brazil. Even in South America, just a little region knows that type of cake.
First of all, preheat the oven to 200 degrees Celsius. Grease and flour a 10-inch ring pan and set aside. Next, blend corn and coconut milk in the blender until obtaining a creamy mixture. Strain the mixture into a bowl and reserve. Then, wash the blender quickly to remove corn leftovers and blend the reserved mixture with sweetened condensed milk, flour, sugar, eggs, and butter until obtaining a homogeneous mixture. Moreover, place the mixture into the prepared baking pan and bake the cake for about 50 to 60 minutes. Then, remove the baking pan from the oven. You can run a knife around to help loosen the cake. Finally, for the coconut glaze, drizzle over the cake and sprinkle the coconut flakes on top.
The brigadeiro, the chocolate truffle. It's such a popular thing that you can find it in birthday parties for kids, or you can find like in wedding parties for adults as well. There is like a big variety of the classic one with chocolate. Sometimes they do like something more gourmet with strawberries and other things. It's very, very common all around the country. Sometimes they look, because it's just like a truffle, they don't think, they don't imagine what is the flavor, or they compare with something that they know from here. And then when they try it, and then they come back for more and say, oh, this is amazing. And then they bring all the friends and introduce the dessert to their friends as well. But sometimes I don't even need to sell the product anymore. They just say, oh, this is amazing. I had this before, you should try it.
For Livia, the truffle is more than a simple dessert. Every time Livia makes a truffle, she can memorize her warm childhood.
When I was a child, it was the family who was planning the party. Grandma would come to our house, my aunties, and everybody would be like cooking together all day. Evening, when all the other guests would come, and I remember that the kids could help with the truffles because it was something simple. So the adults would do like the cooking, and the kids would be like rolling them, making the little balls, the little truffles. This is the most expected moment for the kids when they say, oh, brigadeiro, chocolate truffles and coconut truffles are being served now. So all the kids go to the table, grab what they want. So we have very good memories of this, like being together as a family.
The desserts enriched Livia's life and helped her achieve her dream. And Livia is insisting on homemaking. She believes that the existence of the store does not just provide people desserts and coffee, but also with the wonderful experience of South America. Firstly, chop the chocolate and tip into a large bowl. Put the cream and butter into the saucepan and heat gently until the butter melts and the cream reaches simmering point. Remove from heat, then pour over the chocolate. Stir the chocolate and cream together until you have a smooth mixture. Add any flavorings to the truffle mix at this stage. Divide the mixture between bowls and add in liqueurs or some flavorings, a teaspoon at a time to taste. Then, to shape the truffles, dip a melon baller into hot water and scoop up the balls of the mixture, and then drop the truffles onto greaseproof paper. Or lightly coat your hands in flavorless oil, such as sunflower, and roll the truffles between your palms. Next, coat your truffles immediately after shaping Tip toppings into a bowl and gently roll the truffles until evenly coated, then chill on greaseproof paper. Try crushed shelled pistachio nut to coat in chocolate. Line a baking tray with greaseproof paper. Melt 100 grams milk, dark or white chocolate for 10 truffles. Allow chocolate to cool slightly. Finally, store in the fridge in an airtight container for 3 days. Defrost in the fridge overnight. To give as presents, place truffles in paper cases inside small, lined boxes. Enjoy!
1, 2, 3, 4.
After tasting the unique South America desserts, let's move on to the oldest British dessert store in Preston. Coming with the store manager Aussie, we will experience the most traditional and classic British desserts. We'll not only taste the most local British dessert, but also learn about its rich history and behind British culture. After the advertisement, let's explore the beauty of British desserts together. Will this ever stop killing all my joy?